If you want to play Steam VR games on your Quest 2 headset and want to be truly wire-free, or perhaps you're having issues with AirLink as the other wireless option, then Virtual Desktop is the most mature, stable, and configurable platform there is to solve your problems. And since Meta allowed Virtual Desktop on the Quest 2 without the need for a sideloaded patch, it is now super easy to set up. So here I'm going to take you through the simple steps that you need to follow so that you will be playing your first PC VR game from either the Meta or Steam platform on your Quest 2 headset without any cables in no time at all. Welcome to my tech gear. Let's get into it. Setting up Virtual Desktop to run on your PC with your Quest 2 headset is super easy and just involves three main steps. Get a VR capable PC, get a wireless router, and install some software. That's it. So first up is the PC. Now when running PC VR games, the games are running on the PC rather than on the headset. So you're going to need a PC capable of running VR games. Now both Steam and Meta have released what they regard as the minimum spec for this. Without diving into it in too much detail, you will need a PC with at least an Intel i5 or a Ryzen 5 CPU, 8GB of RAM, although I would recommend 16, and at least an X60 Nvidia graphics card, be that a 1060, a 2060, or a 3060, or its AMD equivalent. You can run PC VR games on lower specs, but you will hit hardware limitations pretty quickly, and some AAA titles like Half-Life Alyx just won't be playable. For reference, in my PC, I've got a Ryzen 5600X CPU paired up with 32GB of RAM and a Nvidia 3060 Ti graphics card, which generally performs pretty well. I do get some low memory graphic warnings in games like Half-Life Alyx, as it only has 8GB of VRAM. However, despite those warnings, I've never had any actual issues in the games. So as long as your PC meets those minimum specs, then you're good to go on to the next step. Next up is the router. Well, that's a router if you live in some other countries. Anyway, as you will be connecting wirelessly from your headset to your PC, you will need a good quality router to give you the most stable connection and ensure you don't get juddery or out of sync video or dropped frames. So to achieve that, you will need a good 5GHz wireless router, preferably a Wi-Fi 6 one. These are either branded as Wi-Fi 6 or 8X routers. If it's branded AC, then it's a Wi-Fi 5 router. It can work with AC routers as long as you still use the 5GHz band. So if you've already got one of those, then give it a go. If you're looking at buying one though, then getting an AX Wi-Fi 6 router is by far the better option. Something like the TP-Link Archer series of routers would be a good choice here. Good connectivity and not too expensive. I'll place some links to them in the description down below for you. When setting the router up, your PC should be connected to it via an Ethernet cable rather than over Wi-Fi, and preferably nothing else operating on the Wi-Fi network either. Now, if you have lots of people in your house using your Wi-Fi at the same time, then it's a good idea to get a dedicated router just for your VR setup. However, I actually just have everything running over a single Wi-Fi network and it's fine. I do, however, make sure that the rest of the family aren't all streaming Netflix at the same time whilst I'm playing. Now, Meta do caution against using Wi-Fi mesh networks for this, but I have a mesh network. I bought the TP-Link Deco X60 and it's been fine. I did have an issue originally where the signal kept dropping frames, but if I went into the mesh network settings and I locked the headset to a single node in my network rather than allowing it to roam, that fixed the issue for me. Hopefully that's a nice little handy tip for anyone else who might be in the same position. With the PC and the router covered, it's now time to install some software. And to play Meta and Steam PC VR games wirelessly on your Quest 2 headset, you're going to need to install 4 pieces of software. You need to install the official Meta Oculus PC app, the Steam app so that you can install Steam VR, and you're going to have to install Virtual Desktop on both your PC and your headset. Fortunately, installing these is super easy. First, we need to install the Oculus app onto your PC. So go to the Quest setup page, and under the Quest 2 AirLink link cable section, click the Download Software button. This will download the installer to your browser's default download location. For most people, once it's downloaded, it will appear at the bottom of your browser window. Simply left-click on the file to run it and follow the simple instructions to install the app. Now, the first time you run it will take you through a first-time setup process where you will need to log in with your Meta/Oculus account, or create one if you don't have one already. Next, in order to install Steam VR on your PC, you do need to install the main Steam app first. So to install it, go to the Steam homepage in your browser and click the Install Steam button at the top of the page. Then click on Install Steam on the following page as well. This will download a steam-setup.exe file to your default download location. Again, for most browsers, it will pop up as a downloaded file at the bottom of your browser screen. Click on that file and follow the simple instructions to install it. If you don't already have a Steam account, then you will need to set one up as you install the app. Now, if you're not sure whether your PC is VR ready, there is a great app in the Steam store called Steam VR Performance Test, which will test your PC for you. If you want to run it in the Steam app, go to the store and in the search box, type in Steam VR. In the search results that pop up, click on the Steam VR Performance Test app. Then under the Use Steam VR Performance Test section, click the green free box to install it. Once it has finished installing, then click on the launch button on that page to run it. This will run a sequence of tests on the PC to test your PC's hardware. Once finished, it will show you a summary screen showing you how good your PC is. If it's all green, then you're good to go. If anything pops up as red or yellow, then it's probably a good idea at looking at upgrading your PC before you go any further. Now install the Steam VR app from Steam. In the Steam app, go to the store and in the search box, type in Steam VR. Now click on the Steam VR app in the search results pop-up list. Then on the following Steam VR page, click on the Play Now or Install button to install it. Also, and this is important, make sure you tick the Create Desktop Shortcut box as you're going to need that to launch Steam VR from your headset in a bit. Then click on Next to install it. Once that's finished, then Steam VR is all set up. Virtual Desktop is the most mature and customizable wireless platform for your Quest, but it does require an app running on your PC and your headset in order to work. Fortunately, that's really easy to set up. First, you need to go to the Quest store in your headset and buy the Virtual Desktop app, which will cost you $20 and install it. Now on your PC, go to the VRDesktop.net website and download the Virtual Desktop Streamer app. Install it and run it. It is a simple single page app. To set it up, you just need to enter your Oculus account username in the top left corner. If you don't know your username, then to find your username, go to the Oculus app on your phone, click on the account picture in the top left, and your username is displayed under your account picture on the next screen. We are now all set up and ready to play our first PC VR game wirelessly from the Oculus Quest headset. So now with the software all sorted, you now need to go and get your first PC VR game. And you've actually got two options here. You can actually go into the Rift store, which is in the Oculus app that you installed first, or you can go into the store in the Steam app as well and browse games under the VR titles category in there. The top sellers section in both apps is a great place to start as it lists all the most popular games on each platform. There's plenty to choose from, such as Lone Echo on the Meta Oculus platform and Elder Scrolls V Skyrim on the Steam platform. My personal favorite has to be Half-Life Alyx. It really is a great game and sets the bar of the best of what you can get out of a PC VR game. Once you've got your games, it's time to play. And playing our first game on Virtual Desktop couldn't be easier. First of all, make sure that the PC and the Quest are fully powered on. Then run the Virtual Desktop Streamer app on the PC. On the Quest headset, select Virtual Desktop from your library. This will start the Virtual Desktop app and will automatically find the Streamer app that is running on the same network on your PC and connect to it. Once that's connected, then you should be looking at the screen of your PC from within your Quest headset. Now click the Oculus menu button on your left controller, and this will bring up the Virtual Desktop menu. Select Games, and it will show you a list of all your PC VR games that you have installed on your PC, whether that's from the Oculus or the Steam VR stores. All of your games in one place. Just select any game to play. Voila! So setting up Virtual Desktop is a little bit of extra effort compared to AirLink, but once you are connected to your PC and launching any PC VR game is super easy, and all of it without any cables. I have placed links to all videos, software, reviews, etc. mentioned in the video in the description down below for you. If you've tried AirLink already, which one did you prefer, AirLink or Virtual Desktop? Do let me know in the comments down below. Actually, maybe I should run a poll on that. Let me know in the comments down below if that's something that you'd be interested in seeing. If you're having issues with playing wirelessly or don't want to pay for a new router or just simply want the cheapest way to play PC VR games, then check out my guide on how to set up and play over a wire connection in the video up here. I'll put the link in the description down below for you as well. If you have enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like and share it. Consider subscribing if you're not. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.